Hello everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the two keywords, which are float and clear. So the meaning of these two words will be discussed later. Before doing so, I would like to show the web page on the right-hand side, together with the HTML code of this web page. So for this web page, I have some headings, and I also include some divisions that include some paragraphs. Okay, so I have one division here, the second division, the third division, and the fourth division. Also, I have the final division. So each division would have a paragraph inside. And the reason I get these appearances for my web pages that I include a CSS file. I already set up the colors for each of the divisions. So for the first four paragraphs, I set up the division color as follows. This one, that one, and that one. And for the final paragraph, I include a border instead of filling the background with a fixed color. Okay. Now let me go back to this HTML file first. Then I also show the CSS file together. Okay, now we can go to the first division, which contains a paragraph with the background color being light green. So you can see that this division is shown below the heading. Okay. Actually, we don't always need to put the division below the heading in this way. Actually, we can simply put the elements on the left-hand side or the right-hand side of the container. So that means we don't always need to follow the normal flow of the elements. How can we do the changes in this way? We can make use of the float attribute. So for the box, which is the first division, I can simply set up the width first. Okay, now the width is only 100 pixels, so you see the box is different from the other boxes, okay? And how can I make it float instead of putting it in the normal flow organization? I can make use of the float keyword. Okay, you can see that the green box is really floating on top of other elements that are placed below the green box. Okay, so the word float simply means that the box is not following the normal flow, and you can see that the other elements are placed next to the floating element. So you see the paragraph from the second box is now starting next to the green box. Same for the third paragraph and the fourth paragraph. Actually, you can see that the fourth paragraph has some part of the text being shown below the green box. It means that the text can wrap around the floating content. So you can see the wrapping effect coming from the floating element. So you see these three paragraphs are placed next to the green box, and you can also see that the remaining paragraphs are still following the normal flow. So I have one statement here. We can set the float attribute to have none as the value. So what is the meaning of it? Let me try it now. Okay, if I set none, I don't really do the floating. So it is just following the normal flow of the elements. Same as the case that I don't input this attribute value pair. So if the float attribute is required to be none, we can simply ignore this instruction, okay? So how about floating the next paragraph? Let me do it now. Before doing so, I set up the width first. Now you see that the width is now 125 pixels. And now at this stage, This paragraph is still following the normal flow, so it is now placed below the first paragraph that was set as having no floating effect. So let me change it to left first. Okay, you can see that the second paragraph is wrapping around the first element that has floated. Okay, so how about floating the orange box as well? I can do it now. Now you can see that the orange box is placed on the right hand side of the green box. It means that even though I've already made the orange box float, it is still placed next to the previous floating element. Okay, so the first one in green is already placed on the left hand side of the container, and then when I want to float the second element on the left hand side as well, I will simply put this element next to the first floating element. And of course you can see that the third paragraph, fourth paragraph, and even the fifth paragraph are going to wrap around the floating elements. So the third and fourth paragraph will start here and here, which are next to the floating element, which is having an orange background color. And of course, the fifth paragraph is also starting here, which is next to the edge of the orange box. Okay. Instead of floating along the left-hand side of the container, we can try floating the elements on the right-hand side. So we can try it now with the blue box here. Now I set up the width of the blue box to be 100 pixels. At this stage, I haven't set the floating condition, so it is treated as none. At this stage, the blue box is simply put below the green box because the blue box is just following the normal flow. So let me change the floating condition for all the blue box now. When I set the float attribute to have a value of right, I can see that the blue box is already floating on the right hand side of the container. And the remaining two paragraphs that are not floated will simply wrap around the space between the floated elements on the left and the floated element on the right. Okay, so you will see that the two paragraphs that are not floated will still having their places here and here. So in order to wrap around the spaces between the left boxes and the right box, we need to have this kind of arrangement by having the floating condition untouched for the remaining two paragraphs. Okay, so let me try to float the yellow box as well. Now the yellow box is having a width of 90 pixels. Because it is still following the normal flow, it is just placed below the floating element in green color. So how can I make it float? I can try the attribute value pair again. Okay, you can see that the yellow box is already floated. And you can see that it is floating on the right hand side. So after setting up the blue box, which is the first floating element on the right hand side, the yellow box is going to be put next to the first floating element on the right hand side. So it is placed on the left of the blue box. Okay. And you can see that the final paragraph is simply wrapping around the spaces that are not occupied by the floating boxes. Okay. Okay, you can see that this paragraph, which is the final one, is going to wrap around the spaces. So is there any way to make the entire paragraph put below the floating boxes? Yes, we have such a mechanism. The idea is to make use of the clear attribute to treat the floating boxes as not floating. So let's see this keyword here. So I'm going to handle the paragraph with the border. So I can try something now. Okay, I can try the clear keyword with a value called left. So what does it mean by this attribute value pair? When we do so, we simply want to clear the floats that are placed on the left-hand side. So we have these two boxes being floated on the left-hand side of the container. So when I use the clear left attribute value pair, I just continue my text directly below the floating elements that are put on the left-hand side. So the paragraph will start just below the orange box. That means I will continue the paragraph after the floating boxes that are put on the left-hand side of the container. Okay, so you can see that the space is given here because the larger floating element on the left-hand side is the orange box. And this border of the final paragraph is not able to go beyond the orange box. So that is the meaning of the clear left attribute value pair. How about trying the right value? Okay, you can see that the paragraph is put below the floating elements that are put on the right hand side, which is this portion of the web page. So you can see that the border of the text is touching the yellow box, because we have to clear the floating condition so that the text is not wrapped around the spaces between the floating boxes. Okay. So again, the right value here means that we are going to clear the floats that are placed on the right hand side of the container. Okay. So in general, we have a particular value for the clear attribute, which is none. So let me try the none value here. So when I set the clear attribute to be none, I'm just wrapping around the text in the space between the floated elements. So you can see that the none value is treated as the default value for the clear attribute. So we can simply ignore the clear equals none attribute value pair. In this case, we don't set any clearing instruction to the web page. Okay. And we have one more particular value for the clear attribute. That is called both. So when I set up the value to be both, it means that I'm going to clear the floats that are placed on both the right hand side and the left hand side. So let me try. Okay, when I set up both as the value, I'm going to clear the floats for both the left hand side elements and the right hand side elements. So you can see that because the right hand side elements would have a larger height, the text box coming from the fifth paragraph is going to be put below the yellow box, which has the largest height of all the four boxes. Okay. So that's the meaning of the word both here. We have to clear both sides of the floating elements. Okay. So this video has discussed the meaning of the word clear together with the word float. You can make use of these words to control the position of your elements so that you can put them in particular positions you like, and you don't always need to follow the normal flow of the elements by using the float keyword. And if you want to clear the floating action, you can simply use the clear keyword. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.